All right, now that we've got the toe stop drawn with our counter bore, counter sink, and our through hole, we have one last step to do, and we're going to draw the little slot that is cut out through here, this little cutout there. Let's come over and look at the sketch. I've got a sketch pulled up here, a little help sheet, and it's just reminding me, remember, it goes up 0.25, over 0.50, and then we're going to have it. When it's done, we're actually going to keep those lines as hidden lines in there. And yeah, that's it. So what we're going to do is we're going to copy. I'm going to kind of zoom into this a little bit. So we're going to start off by taking this bottom edge down here, and we're going to copy it up that distance of 0.25. So you can see that it's going to come through here so that we can get this edge. So I'll start off doing that. We're gonna come in, just use a regular old copy command. I'll take this and I'll take this, press enter. Select a base point. Doesn't really matter where you select as your base point because we're just going up a set distance. We're not copying or snapping to another object. F5, so I can go straight up, and we're gonna type in 0.25. So we've got our 0.25. That looks good. Just made a copy of that whole thing. And now what we're going to do, it needs to come in 0.5. So I'm going to draw just a regular old line. I'm going to come over 0.5. I'm going to come back down 0.25 so we can kind of define those edges that we need there. Now what we'll do is I am going to go ahead and just do the line command. I'll take it from here, and I'm actually gonna hit F5. I'm actually just gonna kind of exaggerate how far it comes out here. So we're gonna trim it back to where we need it, but I'm just gonna exaggerate how far it comes. I've got, now that I've got that, we have it, it comes straight down. So I just wanted to kind of show you that. We do have a visible line. So I just drew this top line back here. We're gonna trim it back to where we need it, but there is like this perfectly vertical part right there. So we're gonna go ahead and draw that line, and we're going to take it at the intersection of that top iso circle and my new line, and we'll just come down. You can bring it any distance and trim it if you want, but we do know that's a distance of 0.25, so it'll save us a little extra work there. Now before we trim this line back, we're going to go ahead and copy this line with this as a base point. We're going to copy it right back down to there. And that looks good. So to clear this up a little bit, we're gonna actually take the lines that we're keeping and we're gonna make those hidden. This will make it a little bit easier when it comes time to trim so we can see what it is that we need to trim. And all right, now we're just gonna come through here and we're gonna use the trim command. So we'll start off by trimming this line and that line. We'll trim this line. We do have a little issue right here. We're going to come back and deal with that later. So we're going to just trim those two blue lines or hidden lines. Now we'll trim this arc right here at the top. And then we're going to trim this, this, and that. Perfect. We are almost done with this view. One quick little thing. Let's go back to this sketch so you can see it. Do you see how this bottom hidden line all of a sudden turns visible? It just kind of peeks right through there. So we need to do that on this one. Just come in here and make that little piece visible. There's a couple of ways that I could do it. I could come in here and, you know, draw a line from that intersection to here, and I've got a visible line. I could trim or shorten that one up. Another thing that you could do though, and I want to get a little fancy here, but we could use the break command. So we could come here to break at point. What that's going to do, the break command will break any line into two separate line segments. So you select the line that you want, just click anywhere on that line, and then it says, where's your breakpoint? And we're gonna go for that intersection. Now, instead of one long line, I have two short, or one tiny short line and another shorter line. So now I can select that one, and I'm gonna put this on, not visible, we're gonna put that on the isometric layer, and oh my goodness, that is it. I am done with the base. We just did an isometric base. So the next video that we'll do, we're going to go ahead and tackle the cleat pin. So we'll go ahead and do that. Now remember that cleat pin has a couple of chamfers in there. So we've got a few issues that we need to tackle with that one. It's also got a hole going through it. So we'll tackle that on the next video, and that is it. So we've got our toe stop base with a counter bore, a counter sink, a through hole, and a hidden slot going through it.